Welcome back to the channel. My name is Haul and I do product and travel review videos. Today, I'm talking about my Rivian, kind of, talking about EV charging in general. I'm just talking about the anxiety that comes with EV charging. So this is my first electric vehicle I've ever owned, is my Rivian R1T. I got it, you know, this year, so it's fairly new. And if you're new to the EV or you're looking into them, you know, there is a bit of preparation and prep you have to do before going on longer trips or taking, you know, a round trip that's going to be more than what your charge will hold. And there's some things you have to think about and some planning you have to do. With some of that comes a bit of anxiety because you've seen things online with, you know, like all the charging stations are loaded up and I can't get into one and blah, blah, blah. There's a whole host of things that you can see. So that does cause a bit of anxiety. Normally, I would just go on my Rivian navigation. I would plot my route and then I would just go about my way and have to deal with whatever was along the route. Recently, I just picked up an adapter so that I can now use Tesla chargers outside of the superchargers because I can't do that. But this goes into my Rivian port. So it opens up my network of charging stations quite a bit because obviously Tesla has the most mature network that's out there. So I've been really focusing on Google Maps lately instead of just using my Rivian navigation. I'm hoping that gets updated to include more charging networks because these adapters are becoming more prevalent. So if you haven't noticed on Google Maps, when you're searching, if you don't use Google Maps yet for charging stations, go ahead and start looking at that because they added some filter features, which has greatly reduced the amount of anxiety I have trying to plan out my trip. So if you go on Google Maps, the filters they do have, so if you just search for charging stations in your area, I have charging stations around New York City. It's not my area. I don't live near New York City. So anyway, the filters they have right now is you can choose the hours. It could be any open now or custom. You could actually set to see if the charging station is going to be open at a specific time when you're going to be there. You can choose any type of plug or you can choose your plugs. And inside of those plugs, you can choose the J1772, which is I have the CCS Combo 1, which is the additional supercharger port for my specific, a Type 2, CCS Combo 2, a CADEMO. I don't know what that is. That's new to me. A Tesla and then a wall outlet. Obviously the wall you're probably not going to be searching for. But so essentially right now I have the J1772 CCS Combo 1 and the Tesla charger because of my adapter. So you can actually choose the plugs and really refine your search results. And then EV charging speed. Right now you can only choose between any and 50 kilowatt or faster. The 50 kilowatt or faster would be in the Tesla supercharger or the Rivian, the fast charge that they have, as well as I think ChargePoint and things like that have some of those. But inside of those, then those filters, you can get a refined search result that really nails in exactly what you're looking for. And like I said, you can even set times of when you're going to be at the charger to see if it will be open or available to use, which is pretty cool. So outside of just using, if you're a Tesla owner or a Rivian owner or any other EV user, you don't have to just stick to the onboard navigation that really focuses in on just specific networks. Google now has allowed you to kind of, you know, it's pretty rudimentary filters at this point in time, but it does allow you to filter a little bit down, which has definitely lowered my anxiety. And having the additional adapter has opened up the network to some of the Tesla network, which is going to be very beneficial because, you know, combining more and more networks across the entire United States is going to be better really for all EV users in general. As they become more popular, that's quite a concern as well because the charging network going to keep up with the demand of the vehicles? We shall see. But Google Maps added some filter features. Thank you so much, Google Maps. I use them quite a bit. And this is obviously quite helpful for finding specific plugs, making sure the charging station that you think you're going to use is actually going to be compatible with what you're looking for. So that, I think that's all I have. If you have any questions on this more specifically, please leave them in the comments below. Hopefully this was helpful for you because it was extremely helpful for me when I found out that they updated this. So I will catch you on the next video. Thanks.